Hello, and welcome to GFC Visions, Growing in Friendship with Christ. This is the third in a series of videos on the Sacrament of Penance and Reconciliation. And so, as I often begin with a hymn, today I'll do a hymn from David Haas called You Are Mine, You Are Mine. It's a very nice hymn for healing and feeling loved by God, which is how He wants us to feel. I will come to You in the silence. I will lift You from all Your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim You as my choice. Be still and know. So let me read a little bit from the Catechism, and then we'll say a decade of the Rosary, as has been my pattern for most of these videos over the past 3 months. Okay, the paragraph where I left off, or the next paragraph that I had hoped to read, is paragraph 1446, and So the title of this section is called The Sacrament of Forgiveness. Okay, the Sacrament of Forgiveness. Christ instituted the Sacrament of Penance for all sinful members of His church, above all for those who, since baptism, have fallen into grave sin and have thus lost their baptismal grace and wounded communion with the church. It is to them that the Sacrament of Penance offers a new possibility to convert and to recover the grace of justification. So, this sacrament is primarily for people who have fallen into serious sin, but we'll see that over time the sacrament became used for really to help to overcome all sin, both mortal and venial sin. And it's not uncommon for people who maybe don't feel that they've committed mortal sin to want to frequent this sacrament as well. Let me read now paragraph 1447, which talks a little bit about the history of this sacrament throughout the years of the church. Over the centuries, the concrete form in which the Church has exercised its power received from the Lord has varied considerably. During the first centuries, the reconciliation of Christians who had committed particularly grave sins after baptism, for example, idolatry, murder, or adultery, was tied to a very rigorous discipline, according to which the penitents had to do public penance for their sins, often for years, before receiving reconciliation. To this order of penitence, one was only rarely admitted, and in certain regions only once in a lifetime. During the 7th century, Irish missionaries, inspired by the Eastern monastic tradition, took to continental Europe the private practice of penance, which does not require public and prolonged completion of penitential works before reconciliation with the Church. And then from that time on, the sacrament has been performed in secret between the penitent and priest. This new practice envisioned the possibility of repetition and thus opened the way to a regular frequenting of the sacrament. It allowed the forgiveness of grave sins and venial sins to be integrated into one sacramental celebration. And this is the form of penance that the Church has practiced down to our day. So just taking a look at that section, we see that really initially the Church recognized that there were certain individuals who, through the weakness, through problems in their lives, would occasionally fall into grave sin that would necessitate that they would have to do a certain amount of penance to become reconciled with the Church and with God. So therefore, they had what was called the order of penitence, and they would perhaps wear rough clothing and live in a bit more austere way than others to show their contrition and to make reparation, if you will, to God and to the community for having broken faith. That's how the sacrament really initially came into being, but as we know, most sins that are committed are venial sins. Many of us struggle with sin throughout our lives that would not be considered mortal sin, but our imperfections and our various tendencies to break the commandments in small ways are things we have to fight against throughout our lives. So the sacrament has now really taken the form of a very beautiful way in which we can strengthen our wills and our minds so that we can battle more courageously against the things in our lives which tend to pull us away from God. And to make us less compassionate, less kind, and less loving people than we know we're called to be. So I feel like I have plenty of things I can bring to the sacrament on a weekly basis to help me to strengthen my will against the various deadly sins which can take root in anyone's heart if they're not dealt with on a regular basis. It's like pulling up weeds, you know, in a garden. If you do weeding on a regular basis and you pull these weeds up before they get to be too big and too deeply rooted, your garden looks good all year long. But if you leave these weeds and you let them grow, and they're going to choke off really the life of the good plants and the good the good flowers and vegetables that you have perhaps growing in your garden. So we need to be weeding regularly, examining our conscience and trying our best to fight against the main, you might say, the main tendency to sin. Because we all have sins that are perhaps predominant sins in our lives. We don't all struggle against the same, you might say, the same difficulties. But we all have our own cross to bear. And the Lord allows us to, you know, Paul said he was given a thorn in the flesh, you know, which he, three times he asked the Lord to take it away. And then Jesus said, no, my grace is sufficient for you. So it's really in recognizing our weakness and our inability, you know, to always do what we want to do. You know, Paul says, I know the good that I ought to do, but I see that within me there is something, there is sin living in me that draws me, that kind of leads me to do the thing that I know I shouldn't do. So if we're honest with ourselves and we bring ourselves regularly to this sacrament, we gradually grow in grace and virtue and in our resolve to root sin out of our lives every day. Let me just read the next section, paragraph 1448. Beneath the changes in discipline and celebration that the sacrament of penance has undergone over the centuries, the same fundamental structure is to be discerned. So this is the main part of this paragraph. It comprises two equally essential elements. On the one hand, the acts of the man who undergoes conversion through the action of the Holy Spirit. And these actions of man are contrition, confession, and satisfaction. And on the other hand, there's God's action through the intervention of the church. So the church, through the bishop and his priests, forgives sins in the name of Jesus Christ and determines the manner of satisfaction and also prays for the sinner and does penance with him. Thus, the sinner is healed and reestablished in ecclesial communion. And lastly, I'll read this last section for today, paragraph 1449, which is the formula of absolution, which is used in the Latin church, the Roman church, and it expresses the essential elements of the sacrament. The Father of all mercies, who is the source of all forgiveness, who effects reconciliation through the Passover of his Son and the gift of his Spirit and through the prayer and ministry of the church. So I'll read this out because it's such a beautiful prayer. And whenever you go to confession in the Latin church, the priest will say these words after as he gives absolution to you. And it's a very, very consoling thing to hear these words spoken over you after you've opened your heart and brought your weaknesses and sins to the priest, to Jesus Christ through the priest. This is the absolution, the formula of absolution. God, the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, has reconciled the world to himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the church, may God grant you pardon and peace, and I absolve you from your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And then the priest usually says, go in peace. And you say, thank you, thanks be to God. And sometimes the priests say, you know, give thanks to the Lord for he is good. And you might respond, for his love endures forever. So, this is such a beautiful, beautiful opportunity for us during this lockdown time, which is hopefully coming to an end very soon. And the churches here will be reopened in less than 2 weeks now, at the end of this month of June. So may God give us the grace to continue to purify our hearts, to fight against whatever sins, the weaknesses that we, you know, that cling so easily. Paul says we have to try to fight against the sin that clings so easily. And may he help us to grow in virtue day by day, to see him more clearly, to love him more dearly, and follow him more nearly day by day.
Nara te turbe, nara te spante, quien a Dios tiene, nada le falta. Nara te turbe, nara te spante, quien a Dios tiene, nada le falta. Nothing can trouble, nothing can frighten. God alone fills us.
I neglected to say a decade of the rosary today, so we'll finish with an Our Father, a Hail Mary, and a Glory Be, in honor of the sacrament of forgiveness. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. May the divine assistance remain always with us, and may the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Thank you very much for watching GFC Visions, and I look forward to seeing you again very soon. Have a great day.